I had a hair transplant, but I'm not happy with the results. What else can I do?
Surgical hair transplants are marketed to be the perfect solution for male pattern hair loss and in select situations for female pattern hair loss. Hair transplant surgery is very time and labor intensive with a significant financial cost. Unlike cosmetic surgical procedures such as facelifts, which usually requires formalized training, such as a fellowship through the American Board of Cosmetic Surgery, hair transplant surgery is offered by a wide range of physicians from different medical specialties without any residency requirement. I'll discuss how I help people who come to me who have had hair transplants performed elsewhere who present with a range of issues, including dissatisfaction with their results. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I have performed hair transplant surgery throughout my career. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This non-surgical treatment for male and female pattern hair loss has been highly sought after with patients coming to us from around the world. I developed TrichoStem hair regeneration based on wound healing technology I used to improve the outcomes of hair transplant surgery. A common complaint about hair transplant surgery is the appearance of low hair density, often described as looking unnatural. Factoring for different ethnicities, a rule of thumb is that normal hair density ranges from about 50 to 100 hairs per square centimeter of the scalp. Unfortunately, hair transplant surgery has limitations technically and in the ability of the scalp to heal effectively to support the growth of hair grafts. This leaves hair transplant patients with hair spaced much further apart than is seen with natural hair density, so hair transplant results can look somewhat sparse. A commonly recommended option is to try and perform a second or a third hair transplant operation. While most ethical hair transplant surgeons will avoid performing hair transplant on men with pattern hair loss in their 20s, I see a fair number of patients who had one or even two transplants before the age of 30. The problem is that many men with pattern hair loss in their 20s are losing hair very fast due to genetics and relatively high dihydrotestosterone or DHT sensitivity. The transplant surgery cannot keep up with the rate and extent of the ongoing hair loss. In addition, about 80% of these patients' contemporaries have a lot of hair, so they aspire to look like other men in their 20s. This cannot be achieved with hair transplant. Many men who start having hair transplant surgery this young try to keep up with their contemporaries. They undergo multiple transplants by the time they reach their 30s. They experience rapid and progressive thinning and are left with very little hair, which was transplanted. The amount of hair available for transplant is not close to the amount of hair that's lost. The peak hair count in the teen years number in about 100,000 hairs. Generally, when someone first notices hair loss, they've already lost about half their hair. As hair loss advances, that percentage becomes much higher. The number of grafts available in the donor area or the permanent zone located in the back and sides of the scalp where the transplants are harvested from ranges from 1,500 to 4,000 grafts. Each graft contains about 1 to 3 hairs. Simply put, a hair transplant cannot replace all the hair that is lost, so transplant surgery cannot cover the whole scalp. Transplant surgery is typically focused on improving the frontal hairline to frame the face. Both temporary and permanent hair loss can be actually caused by hair transplant surgery. The trauma of performing transplant surgery can actually cause collateral loss of existing native hair. This occurs when hair is transplanted close to native hair follicles, where a combination of variables, including direct injury, vascular compromise, and inflammation, result in loss of these existing native hairs. Hair transplant surgeons often rationalize that the native hair was already thinning and was going to be lost eventually. If you are dissatisfied with your results after some time has transpired after your hair transplant surgery, it could be due to not managing the progression of your hair loss after your surgery. Hair transplants do not stop progressive hair loss. Native hair continues to thin after a transplant, leaving behind the genetically resistant to thinning hairs that were transplanted. This often results in a pluggy look, where isolated grafted hair continues to grow, but native hair has gone. In our practice, starting around 2011, I observed that native thinning hair became thicker when we used a combination of PRP, which stands for platelet-rich plasma, and an advanced wound healing material called extracellular matrix made by the company Acell, which we used to help improve the outcomes of hair transplant surgery. I recognize that most men who come for consultation for hair transplant are men whose hair is thinning, not bald. Since thinning hair is already present at a naturally higher density than what can be achieved with hair transplant, I came up with the idea that there was a potential to help my patients with thinning hair non-surgically. This concept became reality as I developed customized formulations and methods of delivery and evaluated the results for men and women of all ages, ethnicities, and variable levels of aggressiveness and, of course, extent of hair loss. I made observations and developed a classification system which helps me optimize treatment plans that are based on gender, age, age of onset of hair loss, degree of hair loss, and rate of hair loss. This became TrichoStem Hair Regeneration, which was so consistently effective that I built a freestanding center specifically for this new approach to hair loss in Northern Virginia. TrichoStem Hair Regeneration addresses thinning hair in men and women by reactivating hair which was not growing due to a prolonged resting or telogen phase, and by thickening hair that was thinning before treatment. We treat hundreds of patients a year from around the world non-surgically with results that in many situations provides better scalp coverage than a hair transplant or even two hair transplant surgeries. We routinely see people who've had hair transplant prior to coming for consultation. There are certain specific situations we see regularly. Hair transplant which was performed within 3 to 6 months of consultation, hair transplant which was performed within the past 5 years and hair has continued to thin, several hair transplants were performed prior to consultation, hair transplant was performed more than once and the patient is considering having another hair transplant. When a patient comes in within 3 to 6 months after hair transplant, there is a potential opportunity to improve the outcome of the hair transplant surgery, particularly at the 2 to 4 month time frame. This is based on the principles of optimizing tissue and graft healing to maximize the growth of the transplanted hairs, as well as activate existing native hairs to grow in thicker, ultimately working in synergy with the transplant to maximize scalp coverage. I do look at each situation individually since a hair transplant outcome can be considerably lower than anticipated even when everything goes as planned. I also advise some patients to wait until the hair transplant is fully healed and their doctor determines that they have reached the point of maximal growth, which is around 1 year to 18 months after hair transplant. Many of our patients who are several years out after hair transplant come because they are looking for options to manage their hair loss, which naturally continued after their hair transplant surgery. As the native hairs thin and disappear, the transplanted hair becomes exposed and looks somewhat more obviously transplanted, or as is often described, pluggy. Oftentimes, these patients have not followed up with the hair transplant doctor for any further management. I discuss the options they have for medical and non-surgical management, as well as the feasibility of additional surgical hair transplantation. It's important to understand that hair loss is progressive and not cured, but managed. My approach is to assess the volume of native thinning hair, which are in the same area as the transplanted hairs, as well as the area where there aren't any or just a few transplanted hairs. With TrichoStem hair regeneration, I can potentially improve the coverage without surgery in these areas. I also discuss for male pattern hair loss patients the role of DHT blockers, such as finasteride, to maximize the longevity of the hair growth cycles, which allows for longer lasting scalp coverage. Generally, I find that people who've had one or more hair transplant surgeries are eager to do a less involved procedure to see how much improvement they can achieve. In situations where hair loss has significantly advanced and hair transplantation is in the plans, particularly in the frontal hairline area, I offer a comparable strategy as previously mentioned. In addition, I find that many of these patients report that their graft survival was considerably less than they had anticipated based on the number of grafts transplanted. This can occur even when the procedure is performed successfully. In my practice as a specialist in revision eyelid surgery and facial cosmetic procedures, I see people where their tissue has been scarred or been compromised by the blood supply after undergoing multiple revision surgeries. In order to ensure optimal healing when I perform surgery for these patients, I use PRP as well as PRP with ACell to enhance the quality of the traumatized tissue and scar tissue to improve the probability of a successful surgical procedure. I suggest the same for someone who's had low graft survival after one or two hair transplants. Essentially, I'm trying to improve the scalp tissue quality after the skin has been traumatized and potentially compromised by the blood supply and scarring. This concept has been successfully applied to patients who've had multiple hair transplant surgeries. Very often, when the patient has had more than three transplant procedures, the transplanted hair can grow with significant variability in appearance. One patient who we recently treated was cutting his hair short to hide the situation. After he underwent TrichoStem hair regeneration, he felt that he could confidently allow his hair to grow longer, and he appreciates how all his transplanted hair looks and feels. It's important to remember that hair loss is not cured, but managed. I spent a considerable part of my career performing hair transplant surgery as the only option to improve scalp coverage by placing thicker hairs in areas where hair was thinning or was completely gone. After developing TrichoStem hair regeneration since 2011, I've actually helped men and women with thinning hair significantly improve their appearance for periods of 3 to 5 years or more without surgery. The marketing of hair transplant surgery does not communicate anything about the limitations and potential for suboptimal outcomes, nor is there any mention of managing hair loss after transplantation is performed. I've been able to apply the technology behind TrichoStem hair regeneration to help people who've undergone one or more transplants optimally manage the ongoing challenge of maximizing scalp coverage for as long as is genetically possible. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your question.